Shout out to the person that inspired this video. The downside is I don't remember who actually inspired me to make this video. It was a comment somebody had left in a community post talking about Le Monarch bow with mid-tree solar on the Hunter with a dodge recharge rate. I don't remember who said it because I deleted that community post, but if you comment, I'll recognize you and I'll pin your comment for that inspiration. But it doesn't just involve the Monarch bow with mid-tree solar, but with mid-tree solar using the Burning Edge, when enemies burn, it gives you recharge rate towards your dodge ability. But like I said, it doesn't just work with the throwing knives, it also glitches and works with the Monarch bow. Whenever you get a clean shot and you do the poison arrows, one shot will give your full recharge rate back to your dodge. But it doesn't just work with the Monarch, but we're gonna start it off with here. So like I was just saying, it's as simple as I just said. You get one clean shot, proccing the poison arrows, and you can see your dodge recharge rate come back. So since you're gonna be having so many dodges with all these builds I'm gonna show you today, we're gonna build out that dodge recharge. Another weapon that works is Jotun. Jotun doesn't work nearly as good as the Monarch bow, but it still works pretty well. It requires around two shots, but that also depends on your mobility value and how high your mobility is to get your dodge recharge rate. If you're at around a 7 or up, you can probably get away with one shot and getting your dodge back, but you can't kill the target. Another weapon that works is Prometheus Lens. The reason why you can't kill the target is because if you kill them, they don't sit there and burn, and the burning damage is what procs the recharge rate of it coming back. But with Prometheus Lens, as you keep shooting them, the dodge recharge rate comes back, so it's a real easy gun to proc this perk with. And the final weapon that I found is Polaris Lance. I tested all the exotics, and these are the only four that I found that works. There could be some legendary weapons that works as well, but Polaris Lance is probably the weaker choice of all four, because you have to get the explosive round proccing to get them burning, to get the recharge rate of your dodge back, so it's not as beneficial as the Monarch, Jotun, or Prometheus Lens. There are going to be some exotics that I didn't name in this video, but they weren't as beneficial as the ones that are in this video, so sorry if I didn't name one that you like, I just didn't feel like they worked out as well. But when it comes to your dodges, Gambler's Dodge is going to be the obvious choice to get your throwing knives back over and over, but there is some kind of benefit with Marksman's Dodge when it comes to the reload benefit of your weapons. So let's say that you have a slow reloading large machine gun, I'm just using this auto rifle as an example, but you can empty out that entire magazine and then swap over to any of the four weapons that I named earlier and then swap back to your large machine gun or any slow reloading weapon that you just get tired of reloading and you never have to reload that weapon again. The reason this build video took so long to get out was because I wanted to leave you with some data to build with all 10 of these builds and some staple pieces that I'm going to be having on all mine and explain to you why I'm choosing these as staple pieces. So we're going to start it off as a tier 6 grenade, and I chose a tier 6 because it was just an average tier and I could work with that and kind of give you some data. That way you can work it into your own build when you start building it out. I'm also going to be using regular impact induction in the video, but enhanced impact induction in my own personal builds with these. Enhanced impact induction or regular impact induction will always vary how many seconds it gives you off your grenade recharge, depending on what tier that you're going to be on, and I could talk about that for a really long time. I eventually cut out around 5 minutes of this video because I started going through all the different combinations of bomber and enhanced bomber, stacking dual bombers, stacking dual enhanced bomber, one enhanced, one bomber, and it started to get really lengthy, and really all you want to know is what did I eventually choose and why did I choose it. And the reason that I chose enhanced impact induction and enhanced bomber with solar plexus is because the difference between two enhanced bombers versus one enhanced bomber was one dodge and one melee. So it took me three dodges and three melees with regular impact induction and two enhanced bombers. When I had regular impact induction and one enhanced bomber, it took me four dodges and then four melees. So I figured I could work with that and still get the benefit of solar plexus, which is 50% bonus damage, which is basically going to guarantee me a stagger on any enemy that's high tier or base game. When it comes to this yellow bar target in the tribute hall, it takes 3 throwing knives with solar plexus, and then 6 throwing knives without solar plexus. And the added bonus perk you get with solar plexus is when you do a finisher, you get super energy because of that. So on all 10 of these builds you're going to see today, it's going to be solar plexus, enhanced impact induction, with enhanced bomber. Here's an example of how it plays out naturally during combat and how you don't really notice it. But the difference of doing a regular bomber versus the enhanced bomber is you'll have to do 5 dodges and then 6 melees to get your grenade back. So I wanted to get more use out of the energy output that I was using on the armor. I hope that makes sense. I had to cut out a lot of tests to go through all the different min-maxing and stuff that I was doing, but trust me, the solar plexus and the enhanced bomber is really the way to go when it comes to what you're getting out of the energy that you're using. Now when it comes to the other artifact perks, always counter charge on all these builds. That way you have a way to get charged with light every time you face a champion. And then of course Inferno Whip, every time you get in front of an unstoppable champion with the Gambler's Dodge, you can stagger them and then do the dodge to get the melee right back. and then it keeps proccing your grenade recharge benefits over and over again. Now let's hop into the first exotic, which was the community post person that told me about it. That's Aeon Swift. So anybody that's having Aeon with you can get extreme benefits off of this, but even those who are not wearing the Aeon still receive a fraction of the benefit. So let's say that you're against a boss target. I'm just using this person, even though I can't damage them, as an example. But you can see with the throwing knives and with the dodge, all that stuff is recharging my dodge. So every time I do that, I'm giving the benefit from Aeon all to the teammate around me. This one's probably my least favorite exotic to use because it just benefits the entire team and not really myself at all. So for that reason alone, it's a good support exotic, but not my favorite. Now when it comes to Le Monarch, you have to get that perfect bow shot to proc that poison arrow. So you have to do it right away as you draw your bow back. But because of that, sometimes you can't get the dodge recharge rate. And that's why I included the Oathkeeper exotic, was because you can hold the bow back as long as you want to, even any situation, and you always get that poison arrow to proc, which is then going to go back to that recharge rate that goes with your throwing knives with Gambler's Dodge to proc Enhanced Impact Induction, to go with your dodge, procing Enhanced Bomber. And the second exotic is going to be Aphidia Spathe. Using Aphidia Spathe is going to give you dual throwing knives, and when you get playing with fire going, you're always going to have your dual throwing knives going, and when you dodge near an enemy, you're going to get both your knives back to keep proccing the Enhanced Impact Induction to again go back to the grenade recharge. So I included it for that reason alone. Aphidia Spathe is still one of my favorite exotics today, even though I don't play with it that much, but Solar Plexus kind of woke this exotic up. Now for the third exotic, Frost EE5, which is one of my favorite hunter exotics. Sprinting increases recharge rates, and then dodging increases your sprint speed. So again, like I was saying, using the Le Monarch bow, or really any of the four weapons that I was talking about, every time you get that shot, you can run with it to make the dodge come back even faster, even though it already comes back plenty fast. But this is probably one of the most easy exotics to proc because you're always going to be running in battle, and having the rapid recharge rate because of that is just going to be even more beneficial when you pair it with the weapons. Now because of the Enhanced Bomber, obviously Six Coyote is going to make this all the better as well, because every time you get a bow shot or the Jotun or the other weapons that I named, it's going to give your dodge back just by one of those bow shots. You're going to get two dodges because of it. So when you mix that with the Enhanced Bomber, that's going to make your grenades come back twice as fast. So you're looking at around like 12 second grenades if you keep spamming the bow shots over and over. And that's why I included it, just because it's an OP exotic for as simple and as basic as it sounds. Using Wormhusk Crown, this is my 1.0 version. I haven't gotten a 2.0 to drop since Shadowkeep, unfortunately. And this is probably the most survival exotic you're going to see today. It pairs well with all four of the weapons, more so Prometheus Lens, because you can watch the charge rate go up. So if you need a quick heal, you simply just spray down a target and then dodge, and voila, you're healed. And you feel pretty much invincible in front of any kind of target, just for the simple fact that you can just hose the target down, get the dodge back, and keep dodging and getting grenades back. So healing and dodging, good combination to have. For the fastest grenade recharge rate, Yunga-Hamakara Spine is going to take the cake out of all these exotics. Getting ability damage recharges your grenade, so knife hits or anything like that, staggering champions, doing dodges, everything that you do with your abilities recharges a grenade by a ton, so using this exotic guarantees you're always going to have grenades. The extra benefits of the perks are kind of just the icing on top. You really don't even need them with this exotic, but it makes it just that much quicker. So the more adds you hit with your grenade or your knife or anything, the faster. You can get like 5-second grenades using this exotic. Here's an example of a 3-second grenade right here. So I'm gonna do the Enhanced Bomber after I throw the grenade. That's gonna proc Gambler Dodge to get my throwing knives back, which is gonna go to Impact Induction, and I have my grenade back within a little over 3 seconds. Now, out of every exotic in this video, the Bombardiers are probably gonna be my favorite with all the dodges that I get, because it seems like you just have infinite amount of Bombardier bombs to go off. Really fun in the Contact Heroic event, or anywhere in the world, really. I haven't tried this in a Master or a Grandmaster because it's not out yet, so I don't know how the damage is going to play out, but definitely a lot of fun to use. And because of the amount of dodging you're going to be doing, and the amount of run and gun ag clear situations you get into if you like to play aggressive, this is just a real fun exotic to just stagger enemies and blow up little smaller file type adds. The bombs don't do a lot of damage, and it's not meant to be an overkill amount of damage. It's just more like support damage to stagger enemies while you try to get away, and that's what it's really good at doing. I might end up revisiting this build for its own separate type of video, because after I started playing with this exotic to make this build video, it really made me play with this exotic way more than the other ones. And I wish I could have showed you a ton more footage with all the exotics. I just didn't want this video to get so lengthy. It was already like 30 minutes, and I had to chop out so much good footage, but that'll be for a build way later. I still gotta get back to Titans and Warlocks, but let's move on down the list to the next exotic, which will be Seal de Hamakaras. This exotic doesn't have much to do with dodging, but it does get benefit from the dodges, but it's more so related to reloading your weapons. So if you're staggering a champion, right after you stagger, you can throw your throwing knives or do a melee to instantly reload any of your weapons. Or if you're a Jotun user and you don't want to deal with that slow reloading ever again, by using the gambler dodge instead of the marksman dodge, your gambler dodge with the throwing knives pretty much acts like the marksman dodge, because every time you throw a throwing knife at anybody, or like I said, the melee, it's always going to reload every weapon that you want to use, whether it be a rocket launcher, an LMG, Jotun, every time you stagger a champion. And then when you pair that with the enhanced bomber and the enhanced impact induction, you're getting the recharge rates. So even though it's not really a dodge type exotic such as the other ones you've seen in this video, it still gets plenty of benefit from all the dodges that you get from all the four weapons in this video. And again, when you mix it in with all the perks towards your recharge rate on your grenade, you have grenades and you're never reloading, and you're using a weapon such as an LMG or any rocket launcher with infinite dodges and infinite throwing knives, that equals more DPS output. Like I mentioned earlier in the video, if I skipped on any exotic that you like to use that's not in this video, I apologize. I just tried to include the ones that got the most benefit off the dodge recharge ability, and this leads us to our final exotic, which is going to be Gemini Jester. Out of all the exotics today, these give you the most combat control because of everybody just pretty much being staggered that's not a major boss target. But if you pair that with Prometheus Lens, really beneficial because you can just watch the dodge meter go up instantly. And if you're doing contact public events, things like that, there's a lot of solar enemies. So against Taken or anything like that, you're always matching shield burns, and your teammates will probably appreciate you more than anybody on the battlefield with how much dodging you're going to be doing. Except for the champions, everybody else is going to be rendered useless the entire battle. So anybody that's not the major boss target or it's not a champion is basically just completely useless and can't do any type of damage to you. Let me know after you try all these exotics and these weapons out today which one's your favorite to use. I'd like to hear what your thoughts are on them. Bombardiers, again, was mine. Even though Gemini Jester is completely ridiculous because, like I said, nobody can basically do anything to you the whole fight. And if you run around the entire battlefield and just keep dodging to help your teammates out, I mean, there's no battle, pretty much. And then for those of you who are curious if I tried this out, because I figured I'd probably have a comment of people being like, what happens if you do distribution with all these dodges? I did try that, but they nerfed distribution down so much that even when I had infinite dodges, it still took me about a minute and 20 seconds to a minute and a half to get my full super back, so it wasn't really worth it. I just fast forwarded at the end instead of making you watch the entire minute. Even with it fast forwarded times two, it was still quite a long time. But I just want to go ahead and just throw that quick clip in there. But as far as some extra benefits you can do for this build and all these builds you see today, you can also use Wrath of Rasputin. And then if you pair Wrath of Rasputin with Burning Cells, that does burning type of damage, which means it'll benefit the recharge rate of your dodge as well. So anytime you blow up a cell and you got Burning Cells on, you can get 3 dodges out of that explosion until you make another cell. So if you wanted to pair that with the 4 weapons you saw today, you can get even more dodging going, plus just extra damage to targets. The main purpose of Burning Cells, it really doesn't do a lot of damage, but what it's meant to do is prevent shielded targets from shielding themselves back up. So if you're doing any kind of match game activities and you're not able to, you know, hit every shielded target, and it's kind of a pain to keep busting their shields off, Burning Cells obviously is meant for, you know, extra damage and things like that, but because it lasts for so long, it can prevent them from shielding back up. And that's really the main benefit that I ever saw that it could do or have the potential to do. But again, sorry that I couldn't show you how I'm building all 10 of these builds out. This video would have been extremely long for me to go through each individual one, so I wanted to show you just some staple perks that I'll be having on each one of them, such as the enhanced bomber, the enhanced impact induction, counter charge, solar plexus, and the inferno whip. But there's obvious choices such as the high energy fire, protective light, things like that you can mess around with. There's going to be 3 empty seasonal slots for each of these builds you'll be able to build and personalize yourself. I wanted to make a build video that even newer players that don't have all the gear in the game can still use right away. More than likely, you probably have Prometheus Lens laying around. You probably have one of these 10 exotics in your vault or in your collection tab you can pull out. And majority of people have enhanced bomber and, you know, impact induction and things like that. So for those that just want a quick fix build that works wonders and does hella work, these are the ones for you, Guardian. But I appreciate you all joining. If you want to hit subscribe and share my content to help my channel out, or you can join the Beast Squad and support the channel that way. I appreciate all the support you Guardians give. It's because of you that I keep making content. Say what's up if you're new to the channel down below. You can also join the Discord to chat with me and other Beast Guardians all the time that enjoy Destiny and die hard at every day. But you Guardians, take it easy. I'll see you all in the next video, next time. In space.